Hello all, myself Dr. A.R. Deshmukh from Department of Engineering Sciences. Today we are going to learn the concept population inversion in laser from engineering physics subject. So first of all, let us understand the laser mechanism. To build up a laser, there are four processes required. First is pumping, that is excitation of electron. Second is stimulated emission of atoms or electron. Third is the lasing process is enriched by multiple reflection between the mirrors. And lastly, a laser beam exists. Some of the concepts that we have seen in my previous video, such as laser action. So basically there are three processes for the laser action. First is stimulated absorption. Second is spontaneous emission, and third is stimulated emission. So stimulated emission is very important to get the monochromatic, coherent, unidirectional light that we considered as a laser beam. And in order to obtain the coherent light from the stimulated emission, two conditions must be satisfied. The first is the atoms or the electron must be in the excited state or the to the higher state, that is an inversion population is needed. Why we say inversion population for this one? Because generally at equilibrium or at the stable situation, the electrons will be in the ground state, and when the external energy is applied to these electrons, they will go into the excited state. So the inversion population is achieved, we can say like that. So in which the more electron will be in the upper state than in the lower one, that is lower one we can say as a ground state, so that the emission of photons will be dominate over the absorption. Because if the more electron will be in the excited state, then emission will be more dominant. But we know that for spontaneous emission, the lifetime of electron in an excited state is very low, that is around 10 raised to the power minus 8 second. And there is another concept, so called metastable state, where the electrons stay more time than in the excited state. So in a metastable state, electron will be stay there around 10 raised to the power minus 3 second. Okay, and that will help for the stimulated emission. That means the more number of electrons will be there in the excited state for a little bit longer time as compared with the number of electron in the excited state, and the stimulated emission occurs. So this is what I was talking about. The higher state must be the metastable state, a state in which the electron remains for a longer time, and as than usual, so that the transition to the lower state occurs by stimulated emission rather than spontaneously. Now the spontaneous emission is depending on the number of atoms in excited state. Since this emission is occurring spontaneously, so the electron will stay there for a less time, that is around 10 to the power minus 8 seconds. So these electrons spontaneously come back to the ground state, and this is depending on the number of atoms in the excited state. Second case is the stimulated emission, and it is depending on two cases. First is number of atoms in the excited state as well as the number of incident photons. So how we are exciting the electron? By giving the energy from the incident photons. So as much energy you will give to this ground state electron, large number of atoms will be go into the upper energy level, and that in return the probability of stimulated emission, that is light amplification, will be increases. The process of getting large number of atoms in excited state than the lower level is called as a population inversion. If we consider n1 is the number of atoms or the electron in the lower energy state, that is the ground state, and n2 is the number of atom or electron in excited state, then we can say that the system in which the population of higher energy state is more than population of lower energy state is called as the negative temperature state. Okay, so here normally at the stable situation or equilibrium situation, N1 is always greater than N2, but what we need, N2 must be greater than N2 for stimulated emission. So for let us understand the process. Stimulated absorption is depopulated ground state. It depopulates the ground state. Stimulated emission, it depopulates the excited state. Okay. Now, as I told you, as a normal, N1 is greater than N2, where N1 is the number of electrons or the atoms in the ground state, and number of N2 is the number of atoms in the excited state. If N1 is greater than N2, that is a equilibrium state, that is absorption is greater than emission, right? And but for laser, what we need, N2 must be greater than N1, and that is emission must be greater than absorption. And to produce more emission, it is essential to have N2 greater than N1, and this is called it as a population inversion. The system in which the population inversion is achieved, that system is called as a active system. So this process is achieved, the process of population inversion is achieved by pumping. The process called it as a pumping. So pumping is the method of exciting the atoms or the electron from ground level to the excited level and to achieve the population inversion. And this method or this process is, we called it as a pumping. There is another definition for this pumping: the process of supplying energy to the medium with which the system is converted into the state of population inversion is called as a pumping. So how we can supply the energy? You can supply energy by a different way, electrical energy or photo energy, right? Electrical discharge method we can use to pump the electron to the excited state. And that's all. Thank you.